A beer. That delicious golden liquid, centuries of years old and known by billions of people worldwide. You can buy it in various sizes of cans and bottles. And today I'm going to take you back 50 years and talk about this little bottle, the Stubby.
That brings us to 1961, a time which Canadian laws prohibited countrywide beer sales. Each beer could only be sold in the province it was produced. This limited competition and expansion. The Dominion Brewers Association got together and decided to replace all 12-ounce pint and 22-quarter-ounce bottles with the Stubby. This standardization allowed breweries to exchange bottles for easier recycling. Stubby bottles were easier to package and could be recycled up to 20 times versus today's long-neck bottles, averaging only 16 cycles. They also cooled much quicker and were much harder to break. The Stubby would now be known as Canada's beer bottle from 1961 to 1984. Over 150 million bottles were produced. So what happened to the Stubby? Why the change? Well, by the time the 1980s hit, beer sales had slowed down, microbreweries were making better products, and interprovincial sales were now allowed. Carling O'Keefe was the first Canadian company to branch out and decided to sell a product to Miller in America. They used the long neck style, which was already a standard south of the border. Many other Canadian brewers followed the switch to the long neck bottles after the success with the U.S. export sales. By the early 90s, the beer store had regulated the use of long neck bottles, forcing every company to switch if they wanted their products sold in stores. This was the end of our short little Stubby bottle. Because of its unique Canadian popularity and discontinuation forcing most of them to be destroyed, Stubby bottles have become collectible pieces and make great man cave displays or even authentic movie props. Brewers have even started to bottle more Stubby products since the 2000s as a nostalgic pitch. So if you see a smaller bottle in stores today, now you can know a little bit of their Canadian history.